not doing common unclean communications matters. Or he is not forming Shadu Sangha, Naam Krita, Bhagavad Sangha. In Mathura and जब ये एक एक पालन कर छेना
श्रीमद भागवत गीता चरित्र वेरी फेमस वर्ड अभी के सुदुराचार सत्य मामन ने कहा दिस इज अ वर्ड विच क्रिएट कंफ्यूजन Even among demigods. What is the confusion? Confusion is that if Anandeva, if one has one point dedication for Krishna and at the same time he is Durachari also, bad character and with so many unwanted desires, if he such person is there. The question arises, how can it be possible? Two things cannot go together. On this point, many people, any demigods, they get confused. But those who take shelter of Śrīla Bhaktivinoda Thakur and carefully understand the commentary of Vishnu Chakradipal and such exalted devotees, they can understand it. It can be possible, Maharaj is saying. Someone may have generated Lokamaya Shraddha. The greed has come in his heart. He has bad habits. Besides the fact that the bad habits are there, but listening from an advanced devotee, he might have generated greed in his heart. It can be possible. Bilbamari Thakur is an example. But Krishna is giving guarantee here that very soon his all bad habits and bad things will be removed and he will become Mahatma. Maharaj is giving here an example. There were two Duracharis, two bad character persons. They were brothers, Bali and Sugri, Lusty. Sugriva was also lusty and Bali was also lusty. Now what happened? Sugriva had desire to serve Ram and Bali did not have. So what was the consequence? So both were lusty, bad habit and having bad habit. But Ram accepted Sugriva and killed Bali. There may be a Duracari, bad character person, a person with so many bad habits, but he is having desire and greed to serve Krishna. Krishna will accept him. And on the other side, if one is very good character person, Maharaj is giving example of Jarasandha. If we see the activities of Jarasandha, he was very quiet person with quiet activities. He used to serve many Brahmins daily. He was truthful person and a sort of celibate also. He was not a bad character person. But he did not have greed to serve Krishna. What was his condition? He was killed by him. Rather, he was killed by Krishna or under guidance of Krishna, he killed him. So even if we have bad habits, we can have greed to serve Krishna. But very soon those bad habits will be removed. Now, Maharaj is coming to a very important point directly related to us. If among others we have such type of shraddha, now he has explained two types of shraddha. One is shraddha because of having attachment to follow scripture, and another shraddha because of the greed generated by Harikatha delivered by an advanced human being. If both of Shraddha is in a living entity somehow or other, but he does not foster them, he does not have Sadhutan, he does not associate with advanced devotee and listen carefully, this Shraddha gradually will become feeble and then will finish up. Veeramangala Thakur Maharaj is giving an example. He was having attachment for a lady named Chintamani. And then he thought that this is very bad thing. He left Chintamani, agreed came in him to serve Krishna, but again he got attracted towards a very beautiful woman. She was fetching water from a well. When he got attracted, he went to her house. Her husband was sitting outside and he asked, "May I talk to your wife?" Husband did not have any bad feeling and he called his wife. Veeramangala Thakur said, "Will you give me two hairpins?" She thought probably some thorn has stuck in his feet and he wants to take it out. She gave very sincerely, without any thought, that two hairpins to him. She never knew that thorn was not
in feet, but it was in heart.
It stuck in feet, that was in his heart. Veeramangala Thakur abruptly took those pins and inserted in his eyes and broke his eyes. This is the part of eyes. They whenever see a beautiful thing that gets attracted towards it. Here Maharaj is raising very important point. If greed comes in a person, this is called Rogamai Shraddha, then he becomes so much powerful that he can do such type of activity. This is a symptom of such greed. If we are having bad habits because of our old habits, that's another thing. But he will not be kapati, insincere. Having desire of name and fame as well as he wants diplomacy and all. No. Maharaj is saying, there are some symptoms who have such shraddha. What is that symptom? That they want to listen and associate with advanced devotee. They want to follow what they are hearing sincerely. So those who are having first type of shraddha, that is, they want to follow the scriptures. They accept guru accordingly. And they get engaged in service and worshipping of Narayan and assured by Vashish Maharaj. And those who generate Rogamai Shraddha, they follow the Guru and Vaishnava in the line of Rupa Goswami and all. You know that, aap log jante hain, you know that. A prostitute went to the Kartha for 3 nights. 3 nights he was expecting that he will come with me and get me. But what happened? He heard the Harikatha. She was so lusty, Durachari, all bad qualities. He has so much taste for wealth, reputation and other things, so much anarts. He has gone to offend Haridas Thakur, but Haridas Thakur was a Mahapurush. Satan prasangam avavajya samvidau bhavante ritakarana rasayana. Tajo sanat asu apabhagvatmani sadhārati bhakti. He went in 3 nights, he was changed, totally changed by hearing the very powerful
name of Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. From so exalted high person like Haridasa, he was Namachar, given by this thing was given by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And three nights he became so pure. How? She left her whole sampatti. Only one cloth he took, only white, and rest he donated everything to greedy Brahmins, and they took it. And she came there, and she, उसने प्रतिज्ञा की या और नहीं कुछ, उसने प्रॉमिस किया क्या? और तुलसी जी की रोज परिक्रमा करती, पूजा करती और 3 लाख हरि नाम बैठ करके करती, वो तो 3 दिन में बदल गई। और हम लोग गुरु जी के साथ में, वैष्णव के साथ में रह करके भी यदि 20 वर्ष में, 25 वर्ष में, 30 वर्ष में नहीं बदलते हैं, तो इसका मतलब यह है कि हमारे अंदर में श्रद्धा भी उत्पन्न नहीं है। कुछ कुछ है वासना तो भी कृष्ण सेवा की, किंतु वो जो श्रद्धा भी दृढ़ नहीं है।
Giving here example of,
I think that you have
understood
what I have
told. Only last part I can that prostitute was changed only in 3 days. And we are associating with Guru and Vaishnava for so many years, we are not changing. We have to see why. It's not because of our Guru and Vaishnava, their Vani, their voice, their Harikatha is weak. But because we are not following it exactly, therefore we are not getting the real result. Maharaj is explaining that Harikatha of Krishna, very powerful, it has been announced by Krishna himself. We should hear from the mouth of those Vaishnava. Which Vaishnava? Who was absorbed in the Harikatha, and Harikatha comes out from their mouth as a fountain. Without any impediment and without any disturbance and without any obstruction. When we hear that Katha, our heart will be quenched and we will advance in bhakti. And if you don't hear it, then our shraddha can be gradually vanishing. So we should take one from today, that when we have come to know the thing, when we have learned it, we will absolutely follow our Gurudev and Vaishnava, and taking this oath, we will find the result.
You are not giving out what you are telling here. वो कारण है परम विजय से श्री कृष्ण संग। इस श्लोक में 4 चरण है जिसके अंतिम चौथा चरण में ये करता है परम विजय से श्री कृष्ण कीर्तन की। वी आर चैंपियन हरिने, हम लोग हरिनाम कीर्तन करते हैं। आप ज्यादातर जगतों को भी देख करके पीछा भी हो गई, संस्कार हो गया है या हरिनाम
करो कि जैसे श्री कृष्ण संगीत। द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट हियर इज बीइंग रेज्ड दैट इन व्हाट इज दे This statement has been given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that Shri Krishna Sankirtan is always victorious. What way it is victorious? It gets victory over my heart. bad habits, bad pressures, unwanted desires and everything. They were so powerful, they could not be conquered otherwise, but this Nam Sankirtan is victorious over them. But at what stage it is victorious? Maharaj is reading wonderful. Clear vision to us. We see sometimes, people take initiation, they are attached to show that they are chanting, they collect very big bead bag and bead and neck bead of 1 kilogram. Some people say that Sridhar Thakur, he was so much exalted devotee. Let us see his mala. So they will steal. It is heard that his dead mala has been stolen. And then they will chant on that mala. Whenever there are assembly of devotees, they will come putting their hand in their bead bag. Showing their hands working very, very powerfully and very, very swiftly. But no lip movement, no chanting from the tongue. Such type of chanting is not mentioned here to say. Paramvijayate Shri Krishna Chaitanya. Maharaj said, any person who takes initiation and having such type of tendencies, frankly speaking, still he is not initiated. It is a abhidhyut rudhi diksha. That means still he has not obtained it. In fact, the all ceremony which is performed at the time of giving initiation in such condition where the person is of this tendency, this means he has been just entered into the class. A registration in class of initiation has been done, not initiation is obtained. The person if he registered in the class doesn't mean that he qualifies the degree. So, when he listens from his Gurudev, and after listening he puts in his heart and his heart changes, that time initiation takes place. Up to that time, initiation process takes place. And when this process is completed, in that completed state, it is said that initiation has taken place. So Maharaj is here very vividly explaining that because of our own stupidity, we are very dedicatedly and with full faith listening from our advanced devotee, having full faith that whatever he is saying is absolute truth. Now he has just come to a point where he thinks that serving Krishna is the only way out to advance in this world. I may lose anything, even my life, but will not give up by chanting. When he comes to this point, at that point, he becomes interested in listening to Hari Katha. He approaches the devotee because he is now interested to listen to him. If such type of nistha, dedication has not come, before this stage, when a person apparently comes in Krishna consciousness, he will have attachment to do other activities, administrative activities, maybe doing kitchen work, maybe doing many other work, but his interest for Hari Katha will not be there. But a person because of false superstition and who is really interested in advancement in Krishna consciousness, he will generate greed to listen Hari Katha. At that time,
he will approach. Now Maharaj is saying here a very important point. That is, frankly speaking, it gave me insight. He is saying that when such person who has generated greed to listen Harikatha and have come to one point of dedication that I will never give up bhajan of Krishna, then he approaches Vaishnava, Krishna arranges him that he approaches such an exalted Vaishnava, which will be really Guru, and such Guru never falls. Otherwise, in earlier stage, when a person approaches a person, any Guru, that Guru may not be absolute Guru. That perfect Guru. But in this stage, when Krishna arranges to for him a Guru, that Guru will be his eternal Guru. At that time, his most of the unwanted desires will go away. Maharaj is quoting here that Nasta Praya Abhadreshu, all those abhadra, unauspicious things, undesirable desires, they will go away. And he will realize some relationship also with Krishna. At least that he is eternal servant of Krishna, this relationship will be realized by him. That I am in eternal servant. At that time when he will chant Hare Krishna, Mahamantra, then this Mahamantra will be victorious. At that time, this shloka, Cheto Tarpan Mahapidam, that cleansing of heart will take care. Whatever unwanted desire will be in us, whatever anant will be in our heart, they will be cleaned by this type of sankirtan. Here Chaitanya Mahaprabhu refers to such type of Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Maharaj is explaining that before that whatever we chant, it is a image of chanting. Pratibimba Namaha. Not Nam, it is image. Like if we see the image of sun in water, it appears that it is also shedding light. But is it sun? It is not sun. The moment water goes away, there is no sun. Similarly, if with insincerity and other many desires we are chanting as referred earlier today, that type of chanting is called Pratibimba Namaha. So, in the following of advanced Guru and Vaishnava, when we chant Krishna name, then this name manifests in our tongue. There is a question that how come this name comes on our tongue? How can we realize it by our senses, material senses? So, Maharaj is giving that this transcendental thing can also evolve on our material senses. The process is not easy.
Tomorrow in 10 morning. After we done at 4. And this is ready within 4. Just at time 5, we will go to pass this camp. 3,000 luggage. And avail that pass. His serial number, what has been given, and he will go tomorrow, first is by gesture, and arrange it. So, Sahi Bhav from Mahapasari. Dusri baat,
hum log अपने समान के साथ ही साथ में हम लोग सबसे पहले भांडीर वन में भद्र वन में जाएंगे। वहां से दर्शन करके मानसरोवर में जाएंगे। मानसरोवर के बाद में हम लोग ब्रह्मांड घाट में स्नान करेंगे और स्नान करके यदि समय होगा तो वहां गोकुल में चौरासी खंभा आनंद भवन और जहां पर उनका जन्म हुआ था गोकुल में वहां जाकर के पास ही में हम लोग प्रसाद पाएंगे महावन गोकुल में। और यदि विलंब होने की संभावना होगी, तो हम लोग पहले वहां पर आकर के प्रसाद पा करके 2-3 बजे वहां से निकल करके गोकुल महावन में दर्शन करके और फिर हम लोग वहां से रावल होते हुए शाम तक मथुरा में जाने की चेष्टा करें। दूसरी बात यह है कि इफ इज नॉट विथ अस ओह सो मेनी पंडा विल कम एंड दे विल डिस्टर्ब एंड दे विल नॉट हैव गिव चांस टू टेल हरि कथा, सो ही इज सेविंग एनी हाउ, सो आई टोल्ड दैट यू शुड पे समथिंग टू डोनेट हिम एंड फास्ट संकल्प। सो आप लोग से जितना जो हो सके बड़नाथ जी के पास में आप लोग जमा कर देंगे।